Hey guys, so welcome back to another video on Brianna Effect. So on today's video, some of my subscribers requested I do a little tutorial showing how I do my intro, my YouTube intro. So on today's video, I'll be doing a tutorial on how I do my YouTube introduction using free apps, because I ain't got no money over here to put into them kind of thing as yet, because I'm now starting my YouTube channel. So first I start by selecting some of the photos I want to use in the intro. Usually it's color coded, similar colors, and I put them in an album so it's easy for me to find. So see the album. So the first app we'll be going into is, I can't remember all of it. PicsArt. Yes, so we're going down to collages, and we're gonna be taking, well, I usually use one photo, so I'm putting three of the same photo in a collage. Share the same pictures in a collage, as you see above, well, on screen, and I put them side by side, which you would see in the intro, in the beginning, my real intro. This one is just a, you know, a little example. So what I'm doing is just playing with the thickness of the border. You could do it how thick you would like. Either you have no border at all, like what I'm doing, or you have a little skinny. You could change the color of the border also. So now that that's saved, we're gonna come out and we're gonna go in Fonto. Yeah, I think that's how they pronounce it, because, well, as you know, YouTube has a particular size in which your video has to be, or your intro has to be, to fit on screen. So we select plain images, any color, and we have to change the size custom, as you see, to 1280 width and height 720. So you're gonna save that, and you see it come up as a rectangle. So you're now gonna go, well, you'll press use. So you're now gonna tap the three dots on the left hand side, and you're gonna add an image, and now you're gonna add that collage into the middle of that black box, black rectangle, and you're gonna size it now to make sure it fits the required size for a YouTube intro or a YouTube video. So you just play with it a bit, you know, make it wider, taller, anyhow, make sure it fits so you're not seeing any parts of the black box below. It's perfectly on top. You're now gonna have to save, so it's the button on the right hand side. You all have forgot, so that's why it's in the tap and draw kind of thing, right? So you tap the button on the right hand side. Of course it's ticking because I'm trying to show somebody something, always, right? And you press save image. So we're gonna come out now, and we're going in the main thing we'll be using to create the intro, which is CapCut. So new project, and we're gonna find that image we would have resized to the 1280 720. So now that we have it in CapCut, we're gonna delete that little ending you see there, because it always appears. You have to make sure and keep deleting it, because if you tap something by mistake, it's always pop up just before you save the video. Make sure it's not there. So I sized it, you see it pop up again. I sized my video to 8 seconds. You just drag it along, because it was 3 seconds originally. And now I'm gonna add my second part. So how I did the background for the second part, I wouldn't be able to show you guys because of copyright. But I took one of my images, same color, everything. I put it in InShot, and I blurred it out. You could also do it in PicsArt. You just blur the image as blurry as you would like, and then you use that as the other background. Don't forget, you have to size it. Go back into the Fonto app, size it to the 1280 720, and then you'll be able to put it in the CapCut. So that's what you see me doing now, sizing it. It's easier when you put the little square in the middle to just, you know, increase the size and then increase the width. Sometimes you really have to play up with the height much, right? So just adjusting it a bit. You don't want any little parts looking weird when the introduction playing is in a little black screen or a white screen on top, though you don't want to see that. You save the image, go back in CapCut, and you add in that one. Now you see the ending come back. You press the plus sign on the side and you add that blurry image. So now that we have the two clips, we're gonna add an effect on the first video. So you're going into effects, video effects, basic, and you're gonna just go through, see which one you like, whether it's the shake, the zoom, fade out, anyone you want, and you add that onto your video. So you see I added the shake, and well, make sure it goes for the full duration of the video. And now you have to add a transition so that it wouldn't jump straight into the next clip rough. It will go in smoothly, either it will fade away, you know. So I selected the first one, then and now. So as you could see, it will fade in, right? So we have one effect on the first clip, which is a shake, and we have a fade in transition. So now I'm gonna put in my YouTube channel name. Usually I would do this using PicsArt, but screen recording is, I believe, illegal, or they have some copywritten issues concerning it. So yeah, so I'm just showing you guys how you could do the font in this app here. I kind of like this one, so I'll use it. So I just change in the color of the stroke. The stroke is the lining on the outside, so I change that to black. And the inner color, I just put that to red. Because, well, that's the team you're working with. A kind of red and greenish kind of, you know. So, adjusting it, putting it exactly where I want it on the clip. Usually, I like it to the bottom, to the right-hand side or the left-hand side, anyone. To put it wherever you like. And just as you did before, you have to set up the animation or the transition in of how you want your words to appear. So you wouldn't just let it pop up before anything else. You want it to, you know, fade in, or some people like it to, some letters go up and down like it's on a Ferris wheel, you know. Yeah, but different ways. So I did the fade in so that when the video opens and you see the image, you see my name one time. And mommy sneezing in the background, I hope you didn't hear that. Okay, so if you guys are like me and you find it didn't have enough on the first clip, then you'd know why. Adding another effect now. So you're going into mood before we went into basic, and this one would either give you a sparkle or aura, butterflies, anything you choose. Just go through it, make sure you choose the one you like most before you, you know, move on. Take as much time as you want. Nobody rushing you. Rushing your Lord. So those are just some of the examples above of what we're doing here. Right, sorry, video effects. And we in the moods category. So as I say, if I look to tell Ole how long it will take for me to actually find the one I like best for this video, we'll be here forever. So I just decided taking a simple sparkle so I can move on, you know, get this completed to show you guys the intro. Right, so I'll be using that one, gold glitter. And well, don't forget to size the video effect to the video. You'd have to drag it up until you see that little white kind of like an X in the middle there. That's the transition. Make sure and drag the purple bar, which will be a video effect, up until that. Okay, so for the third clip, I like to add three clips. We're gonna, you know, we all do these little Snapchat videos or little cute pics we might have, videos preferably. So I just selected two of them because I recently got my hair done, as you guys know. So I selected two of those clips, and well, I can't show you guys sadly because of, yeah. But I resized them in the InShot app. That way my border will be on, sorry, the background, the faded back will be on the right hand side, because I wanted to insert a screenshot of my phone or screenshot of my Instagram page, which will hopefully help. Okay, so now working on the second part. I'm gonna go in the phone. I remember I told you the album with these photos that I put aside specifically for this video, color coordinated, meaning they're all in the same outfit or just different colors that could go along in the same picture. You want it to look pastel with a green and a pink, and no. So I put it in the photo now. You don't have to put the photo straight, you could put it crooked, anything that looks best. And remember I told you guys, you have to cut your clip or cut the image, make sure it fits within that middle clip or that first clip or that last clip. You don't want a picture from your middle clip popping up at the end when it's covering something that you want your subscribers or your followers or the new people coming to your channel to see. I'm just trying to figure out which images I like best. This one bright because it's similar to the background. As I told you, well, I took all of them the same day actually. And yes, so I have two images and I'm gonna take another one after I resize, which is similar color but different outfit, different day. Well, they are hungry. I'm trying to eat corn soup, but I can't really eat while telling all they'll be snapping in the background. I don't like snapping. So right, so I just adjusting or seeing how they'll fade in. Remember I told you I have to do the animation in and the out of each clip, so you select them, you do the in, either you want it fade in, flip in, roll in or roll out, but it's smoother for it to go in. Seeing as we have three clips, when this first clip ends, you want it to come in smoothly to the second clip and then smoothly to the last clip. Right. So this is the third image I found. As I said, different outfit, different day, but it's similar in colors and it's not clashing with the background. It's not a beach picture, you know, the other images wouldn't look as good. And as I said, you don't have to put them straight, you could have them crooked however you want. Also, keep in mind, if you're using images, timing is important. So try and space out the seconds. As you see I'm doing, I'm trying to time it best. So you see it pop 1, 2, 3. You don't want a photo coming in 1, 1, 2, or 2 coming fast and then the last one sticking. No, make sure the timing flows. So if it's 2 seconds apart, 3 seconds, make sure it flows. Now it's sticker time. So you know, usually the stickers would be where we would put the little subscribe tab, or you would put your little Instagram symbol and your name next to it to get people to subscribe to your channel.
So as we did before, I'm going to take a second.
music. In fact, many of them we do not see. Some of them as a music for the effect at all. Some of them have been for a while. You can now add an overlay, so you can add another layer, and that final layer will be that frame, which will then go on top of your screenshot, so it will look as if you know you're looking at someone's phone while they're on your Instagram page. So you see me scrolling down because I had the phone screen saved from a while ago, from a last edit intro, and sizing it now to go over the screenshot. So you see, make sure you see no empty spaces as best as you could, right? So that's how. Once again, most important, make sure you cut the length of time that the phone, well, your pictures appear on screen. Make sure it fits within your last clip. Make sure you do the animation or the transition in, it flows in, or it flips in depending on how you want it to come in to the last clip. And well, the final part is getting audio. Audio is something by itself. It's really difficult to actually get music where you wouldn't get copyrighted, but most times, which is not, you know, not advised, but it works, is you go on, well, you just see me adding some extra words on the screen stating don't forget to turn off, what should I say, don't forget to turn on the notification bell, right? So that will appear on my last clip. But as I was saying before, it's very hard to get music where there's no copyright restrictions. What usually people do, as you would see plenty creators, they will take a popular song and they will adjust the speed of the song. So they will make that song faster, which will make the voice a little squeakier, or they'll make the song slower, which will drag out the voice, because you're trying to change the pitch of the song and the beat itself so that, you know, it doesn't sound, even though it clearly sounded like the original, so that you kind of alter it into your own version. It's not your own version, it's silly people's song, but yes, altering it into your own version for you to use for this purpose of the intro. So I just playing up with different styles of how I want the don't forget to turn on your notification bell, of how I want that written. I just playing up with the different styles. Pay in mind that it's like a color-coded something, so if you use red before, green before, yellow before, try to stick with those same colors. Don't use pink all of a sudden and blue unless you like that rainbow effect, right? So I'll put in my little subscribe sticker on top. They don't forget to turn on the notification bell. I'm gonna add in, you know, my audio. But first, before you add the audio, save the clip. You don't want, you know, anything to happen and it lost all this little work we now work for this 22 minutes here. Right, so now that we have it saving, we're going to go back into the same CapCut and we're gonna select new project and we're gonna open that saved video. I'm gonna add the song. So how we add the song is, as I told you, I have a audio from before from my screen recording. I did, I adjusted the pitch and those stuff, and well, I'm adding it in now. So most times if the audio is too short for a clip, that means it's too fast, meaning all you need to do is slow it down. It will extend the length of your audio and then you'll be able to cut your audio clip. You don't want to cut your video, cut the audio, right? Okay, so as I mentioned, you select your audio and you split and you just delete that extra piece and delete that ending that just keep popping up and you save. Okay guys, so here's the finished product. It's not gonna make you feel no way. My heart are yearn, but you already know that. Fight for you like the Navy, I'm a little soldier. You give me everything my one, boy, you never want.